So I'd like to have a look at some of the cables we're going to use predominantly in the workshop and predominantly initially on our course using this style of cable, which industry like to call twin and earth, and we're going to call it PVC, PVC, twin and c.p.c. Hopefully all those electricians out there aren't falling off their chair with laughter, but that's what we will call it at college, twin and earth out there in industry. So start off with the cable used widely in industry for installations such as domestic dwellings and is known as twin and earth out there on site. At college, we're not going to call it twin and earth, unfortunately. We're going to call it PVC, this being here, the grey outside sheath of the cable being the first layer of PVC offering mechanical protection. And then the second one, so PVC, PVC, is here, is the insulation around the live conductors. So PVC, PVC twin for the two live conductors and CPC. On site, twin and earth, two conductors and what they call an earth. So we've got PVC, PVC, twin for two live conductors and CPC. CPC standing for circuit protective conductor. On our PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, we have a brown conductor known as line, a blue conductor known as neutral. Together when we describe them, so when we're talking about the two conductors together, we call them live conductors. So if 10 amps was flowing down the line conductor, down the brown one, 10 amps would return through the neutral conductor. So therefore they are both live conductors and a CPC. Difference with the CPC is it is uninsulated. It is uninsulated because it will not carry current under normal conditions. The CPC will only carry current when there's a fault to earth. The maximum time it will carry current for is 5 seconds. However, there are other maximum disconnection times. The other most common one that we'll look at is a maximum of 0.4 of a second. So default position at the start of your course is that the CPC will carry current for a maximum of 5 seconds. However, we will look at other maximums as we go through the course. As a CPC is unsheathed throughout the run of the cable, we need to sheathe it to identify a termination point. So therefore we need to cover it in a sleeving, a PVC sleeving. In this case, it's green and yellow to identify it as the circuit protective conductor. Okay, they're going to call it earth on site, but we're going to call it CPC here at college. This cable is also described by its conductor size, as well as being PVC, PVC, twin and CPC cable. We describe it by the size of the live conductors. So in this case, it is 1 millimeter squared. So the area of the conductor is 1 millimeter squared. And we always describe it on the live conductor sizes and not the CPC. However, in a 1 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable, the CPC is also sized 1 millimeter squared. Okay, as we move through the cable sizes, the CPC is smaller in cross-sectional area than the live conductors for the same reason it's not sheathed throughout its run, because it will only carry current for a maximum of 5 seconds, okay, when there's a fault to earth. Therefore, it can be a reduced size conductor compared to the live conductors. Let's look a little further at the construction of PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables. This one is 2.5 millimeter squared. Conductor sizes up to and including 2.5 millimeter squared always come as a solid copper conductor. So both the neutral and line in this case are solid copper 2.5 millimeter squared. The CPC is a reduced size of 1.5 millimeter squared and again is solid copper. We must also identify this insulating material here for the on-site guide and regulations according to the IET. This one is thermoplastic PVC insulating around the conductors and has a maximum operating temperature of 70 degrees C. So in other words, when a conductor carries current, it gets warm. The temperature around the cable obviously also gets it warm. That's called the ambient temperature, and it can work up to 70 degrees C. So I will be asking you in the classroom and in the workshop, what is the maximum operating temperature of this type of insulating material, which is thermoplastic PVC, and it's 70 degrees C. When we move from 2.5, next cable size is 4 mil, 6 mil, 10 mil. So if we look at a piece of 6 millimeter squared PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, we can see now the copper conductors have gone beyond 2.5. So the construction this time for the live conductors is 6 millimeters squared. So, and it's now stranded solid copper. Okay, the CPC must be 2.5 or less because it's one solid copper conductor. And in this case, the CPC in a 6mm² PVC twin and CPC cable is sized 2.5mm². So we can see the difference in construction as we move through the cable sizes. So 6mm² cable, a 6mm² stranded copper line and neutral conductors, but the CPC is only sized 2.5 and therefore is of a solid construction. So we looked at the basic construction of PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables. The outside grey PVC offering mechanical protection can also be white in colour. The ones that are white in colour now in modern cables are low smoke, zero halogen cables. So when standard grey PVC sheath cables are burnt, it gives off a black dense smoke. Some installations require that to be reduced. In order to reduce the smoke given off by PVC, they insist on low smoke, zero halogen cables, which are white sheath PVCs. They can be a little bit more tricky to put 90 degree bends in and a little bit more tricky to pull in. They're a little bit more rigid than standard PVC cables. You've got a little bit more flex in them. So that's another consideration. So the PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, the twin and earth cables that we will be installing in industry and in our workshop, have a brown line conductor and a blue neutral conductor. However, this was changed in 2004 to these colours. Prior to 2004, we were using conductors that were like so, where we had a red line conductor and a black neutral conductor, and as before, a bare CPC conductor that was sheathed green and yellow at terminating point. So bear in mind that the installation that you put in may have a brown and blue conductor for line and neutral, but we may well face regularly conductors that our line is red and our black is neutral. As well as installing PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, we will also be installing PVC three core and CPC cables. These conductor colours are brown, black and grey, and as before, a bare circuit protective conductor identified at terminations with green and yellow sleeving. As the with the twin and CPC cables, these colours were changed to these in 2004. Prior to 2004, our colours were red, yellow and blue within our three core cable, so bear that in mind as well. We'll just run through a few of the other cables we're going to use very early on in our course. This is a flexible cord. Anything up to and including 4mm² in this design of cable is called a flexible cord. Over 4mm², first being 6mm, is a flexible cable. And we would describe this one as 0.5 for the size of the conductors within the cable, three core flexible cord. Now, we're not going to call it a twin and CPC or earth in this case. We're always going to describe the flexible cord and flexible cables as the number of conductors. Reason being, in a flexible cord or a flexible cable, they're always all the same size. So the neutral, the line, and in this case, the earth in this cable are all 0.5mm². So therefore, it's a three core flexible cord. So this type of cable will be used later on in the course, and it's a steel wire armoured cable, this part here being steel, armouring around the cable, offering mechanical protection. And we've got the conductors, in this case it's a four core one, so we've got brown, black, grey, and the introduction of a blue conductor at this stage. If it was a two core steel armoured cable, it would be just brown and blue for the two cores. If it was three core, it would be brown, black, grey. Okay, we've got the four core steel armoured here. The little change on this cable is the actual insulating material around the conductors is no longer thermoplastic PVC, but thermosetting PVC. And that has a maximum operating temperature of 90 degrees C and not the 70 of thermoplastic. So thermosetting PVC insulated conductors. And that means that for the equivalent same size, so if it was a 2.5mm² PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, or a 2.5mm² steel armoured cable, the steel armoured cable can carry more current for the same size of conductors because these can be run hotter up to 90 degrees C with the thermosetting PVC, sometimes called cross-linked polyethylene, and that's XLPE cable. Next type of cable is PVC singles. This time there is no grey or white outside mechanical protection, they're just single insulated conductors, being line, CPC and neutral. The actual mechanical protection offered by the grey outside PVC sheathing of PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables is now going to be offered by something such as
plastic conduit. So the conduit becomes the mechanical protection. The circuits are inserted inside the conduit, which offers the protection. Therefore, the conductors themselves only require to be single insulated PVC. And this is thermoplastic PVC, so therefore has a maximum operating temperature of 70 degrees C. The mechanical protection could also be offered by steel conduit, plastic trunking, steel trunking. So we're looking at single insulated cables, further protected by the wiring enclosures, and in this case, they're PVC single insulated conductors. The last cable I'm going to look at in this presentation is the concentric cable. For those of you who have watched my video on earthing arrangements, TNCS, I talked about the type of cable that goes into the bottom of the cutout being a concentric cable, one that has a copper combined protective earth neutral and a center conductor. Unfortunately, it's in red insulation nowadays, it'd be in brown, but center conductor being the line conductor as an aluminium conductor itself. So this conductor here offers both the neutral and protective conductor, and the center aluminium being the line conductor. And that was for the TNCS earthing arrangement, this type of cable being a concentric cable. So let's hope that's helped us with a basic introduction to our cables, cables construction, operating temperatures, and names of conductors as well. So we'll be down in the workshop, we'll be using these cables, and I'll be expecting you to be relaying the information about the name of the conductors, maximum operating temperatures, and their basic construction as we look to move through our course.